everyone. Happy whatever day it is, wherever you are. For us, it is travel day. So we are headed on a trip separately. Chloe and I, like you saw in the last video, are going to Franklin, Tennessee and Nashville. And Sam and Christian are going to Scottsdale, Arizona. And we are gonna be gone from today, Friday, to Monday. So I wanted to show you really quick, since I kind of showed you, well, not kind of, I did show you my packing process. I want to show you like what I do before we travel and what I try to do in our home before we leave, so that when I come back, I don't feel extremely overwhelmed. I don't have tons of laundry, like, you know, waiting for me in addition to everything that I'm bringing back. And it's just kind of a way for me to prep the house so that when I come back, I can still feel at peace and not just like, oh my goodness, now I'm back, everything's crazy and I gotta go. So I will show you what that looks like. Really quick, I wanted to show you two things that came in the mail. I get quite a few questions about like my skincare routine, what my kids use, things like that. I can add that to one of these vlogs if that's something that you guys would be interested in seeing. I do have all of these things linked on my storefront if you're curious about that. They're things that we have literally tried hundreds of, and these are the ones that we have found work. This is the night cream that I use. It's by CeraVe. It's the Skin Renewing Night Cream. And then this is the, Chloe, do you use this at night or in the daytime?
I use it all the time.
Okay, she uses this all the time. It's the Advanced Snail 92, and it's by Course, I don't know if it's Cosrx or Cosrx, I don't know exactly how they say it, but this brand is phenomenal. I believe it's out of China or Taiwan, I'm not exactly sure which. But this brand is by far one of our favorite ones. We also, well, we as in the kids, use the Snail Mucum. And like I said, that's in the storefront under Beauty or something like that. You'll be able to see it. But we absolutely love these products. So these came in the mail. I need to get those put away. Chloe is finishing eating and drinking her coffee. The golf bags are both ready and packed. I've got a load here that I need to fold. These are all of the towels. I always wash all the towels before we leave. That way we come back to clean towels and not just gross ones that have like smelled over the time that we've been gone. This is a gift that I got from a friend. Absolutely one of the softest blankets that I have ever felt. Love it. So I need to put that away. And then here, this is what the laundry room situation is looking like. I have got the kids' sheets in here washing. I've got the last load of like just all the clothes washing. That way I can have all of those dried and put away before we leave and not come back to that. And then in here, I have already washed my sheets. Those are things I need to deal with when I come back. Those are decorating stuff, but we're not doing that today. I've got all of our sheets right there ready to go and put on and ready when we come back as well. So I'm quickly gonna make this bed, fold those towels while the kids are getting themselves dressed. We actually have a snow day today. If anyone can tell me why, I would love that. Like, we've had two snow days this week that were absolutely unnecessary, and I'm not understanding why. I mean, it's cold, yes, but like, okay, you have a coat, right? Like, I don't get it. That's kind of the joys of being at private school. It's like you get to make that call on your own and you don't have to follow other districts and stuff. But anyway, I digress. So The kids are getting their stuff around and ready. And then I'm gonna do this, fold the towels, and I'll meet back up with you. Christian is making coffee and gonna eat breakfast. And then once he's done with that, he's gonna start the dishwasher. That way the dishes can be washing and we can get those all put away back in the cupboard before we leave.
The other thing that I do is I go through and clean all of my bathroom hard surfaces and toilets. And I just get all of them nice and clean. That way, when we come home, again, that is not weighing on my shoulders to get done or somebody else to get done. It just kind of allows the house to be clean while we're gone and breathe until we get back. Keep in mind, this is not a deep clean. I'm not really lifting stuff. I'm not gonna lift this and clean behind it. It's more of just like a really quick dusting and going over. Obviously, you know, I'm cleaning the sink and the soap dish and all of that just because those get really gross and the mirror. But as far as like, you know, my weekly clean the bathroom. This is not really it. It's kind of more so, I guess you could think, like, if I had to have someone come in my home while I was gone to get something or to do something, what would I be okay with them seeing? It's just kind of more along that line. Kids have already done their bathrooms. I just need to do Sam in my bathroom and then the other bathroom on this floor. And that's it. I will also clean the toilet, but I'm gonna spare you from having to watch that.
You know the world is beautiful, so beautiful. 'Cause you know the world is beautiful, so beautiful. And I just can't hide how I feel about you. Nothing can take that.
Alright, so we are making great progress. We've got a load of laundry already done. I washed them all at the same time with those color guard things that I've showed you guys, but then I dry them separately. Otherwise, it would just take forever because there's like jeans and sweatshirts in there and stuff. I don't normally like do my laundry like that, but on the days that I need to like throw it all in and get it done super fast, that is what I will do. We've got the dishes here drying so that we can just hurry quick and put them away. Christian is actually gonna use my other backpack. Can you put this away, bud?
Yeah.
Today, or this trip, whatever. So he's got that on there. That way his attaches to his suitcase as well, because he's gonna be also hauling the clubs. So we've got that all ready to go. My bag is all ready to go with my shoes. I have been doing a little bit of editing for the video that is supposed to drop today, which is Friday, because I needed to do just a couple more things of the packing stuff. So I've got that waiting for my computer to go in. That key fob gets left in my car because my dad's going to take us to the airport. All my rings are waiting. We've got a straggler hairband. This right here is Sam's. I need to remind him to take that and put it in his bag. He's on his way home from work. And then we've got some last minute, just want to make sure I've got all the charge I can get. Things taking place right here. Christian is actually downloading some videos on his iPad. So he's got that there. Laundry is all done. The last load is drying. and that is all clean. And then these things I still need to run upstairs. They've been here all week. So I've got to get that up there. There's the dog's vibrator collars to take with them to my parents. What else have I shown you guys? I think I showed you the bedroom, but let's just double check. So Sam's suitcase is there, just waiting for him to zip it up. As you can see, Daisy has been here. And then the bathroom. This is all cleaned now. And over here is all clean. These are just two things that Sam needs to pack when he gets back. Alexa, turn off the bathroom light.
Okay.
I'm so sorry if I just messed up everyone's device. I never think about that. In here, this is kind of my overflow room right now. I haven't gotten any decorating done yet this week, and I'm not super worried about it. I'm actually not worried about it at all. But these are the things that we're going to be doing when I get back. So we've got our pictures for upstairs. These are the things you guys saw for Chloe's room. And then these are items that I've gotten from the thrift store over the last couple weeks that I want to DIY and put in my decor, like my winter slash spring. These right here are trees that are going in the living room where the Christmas tree was over there. So we're gonna do that when I get back. I used my birthday and Christmas money to get those. They're not super expensive, so I will link those in that video when we do that. Here is the ottoman that replaced the one that had the burn mark on it. So I think she's super cute. I love it. Over here, I'm just gonna fix these because I'm that girl. This right here, I need to deal with when I get back. This is the one that had like the little broken handle. And so we'll do that when I get back. These, I've had people ask about them, but not commit to them. Daisy is terrified that I'm going to leave her. So she's like right up on me. And that's kind of where we are. Chloe's bringing her suitcase down, so I'm just waiting for her. Like I said, these are drying. So that is where we currently are. I think we're in a really good place, and I can leave here knowing that I'm not coming back to just total disarray. The kids put their sheets on, so those are all done and taken care of. I'm just waiting for these dishes to finish drying and that load to finish drying. And then I think we are ready to get up out of here. It's like tiny, tiny flurries right now. Still nothing that is like hindering us from anything. The one issue, like fly-wise, that might be a little bit of a thing, I'm not sure, is we've got some pretty high winds, like 30 mile an hour winds. So I don't know, that might be a little bit dicey, but that will be in another vlog. You'll have to watch the vlog after this of Chloe and my trip to see how our whole flying day went, our trip went, our comeback day went, because it's supposed to snow there that day. Like, it's just gonna be a whole thing, but that is gonna be in a separate vlog. All right, Sam is home. There is his backpack. And then he's got his stuff over here that he just dropped off. Chloe's got her bag down here, the one on the top, and then her coat. Mine is all there. And then all of the things are done in here. That is just finishing drying a rag that I rinsed out and didn't want just like sitting. But other than that, we are ready to go. I wanted to show you one last thing. I go through my fridge and any meat that I did not use that week or anything that I can freeze, I go ahead and just throw into the freezer. That way it doesn't spoil. Like these things, January 11, January 9, like they're still fine if I was here this weekend, but I'm not going to be, and I don't want to waste them. Like that's ridiculous. So I just put them in. I put Christian's last steak in there, and that way when we come back, it is ready for us, and I don't have to buy meat for the next week. All right, everyone, I hope that this video was helpful for you. I hope that it just kind of gave you maybe a little bit of inspiration of what to do before you go on a trip. Sometimes I do all of these things the same day, like I did today. Sometimes we have earlier flights or we're having to, you know, take off earlier in the day. And so I will do all of that the night before. But regardless, I try to prep our home to be in a place to welcome us back home peacefully. If you followed along with me today, I would love it if you would just post the emoji of the day down below, which is a house, and let me know that you hung out with me this whole video. All right, friends, until next time, just remember, be intentional about what is important and necessary and eliminate the rest. I will see you in Tennessee. Bye-bye.